Man, I'm in a great mood. We are about ready to go see The Road, which is one of the biggest Oscar contenders of the year, starring Viggo Mortensen and directed by John Hillcoat. Man, I can't wait for this movie. It's going to be
good.
Awesome.
I can't wait.
It's like it used to be when the sun came out.
We're going to die.
We're not going to quit. We are gonna survive this.
Hi, I'm Eric Moline from Scene Stealers, and with me is Trevin McGee from NKC.com again. Trevin and I have both read the Cormac McCarthy book that the Road, directed by John Hillcoat, is based on. And Hillcoat, of course, is the guy who did The Proposition,
another uplifting, you know, triumph for the human spirit story.
No, yeah, he definitely goes for the downbeat.
This is intense.
This movie is actually it's a very nerve-wracking and emotional experience, and it's a lot like the book in that
respect. It's intense. It's absolutely intense, and the book is too. And if anything, I mean, Hillcoat should be just credited for maintaining that sense of intensity throughout the entire movie. It's relentless. It doesn't really let up ever. Yeah. And also, you know, I mean, Viggo is great.
Yeah. Viggo Mortensen is a father, and he is shepherding his son through a post-apocalyptic world, which, by the way, we never know why this happened. We don't know why the world ended up this way. Honestly, it's beside the point, and I'm happy that they left that out of the movie. If the world ends this way, then it becomes basically survival. And why bother surviving if this is what you're leaving to your children? Yeah. And the whole movie really gets this point across through its visuals.
Oh, yeah. But I couldn't help. There's a huge commitment to that. I mean, throughout the entire movie, just the world is dead and gray and dark. And
I couldn't help but miss what I really enjoyed about the book, which was the prose, which for me, reading that book was almost like reading a very long poem. Cormac McCarthy, just the spirit, the things that the father thinks about in his head. You know,
it's like a road journal. It's like a road journal through the post-apocalypse. Basically.
Yeah. You know, having read the book, I have to say that I probably like this movie a little less than I might have if I had seen it. But the more that I think about it, the more I think that this was as true to the book as it could possibly have been without having
they're
narration the whole way through.
Yeah, there are just certain elements that can't carry over. And there's going to be some, you know, like, contention over the use of flashbacks throughout the movie. And I don't really see the need for that. It makes sense. It works. And it's the only way they really could have given that extra backstory, you know? Mm-hmm. Like you said, unless they narrate the entire thing, and then it becomes a comic book movie.
Barring the poetry, the narration from the book, I think Hillcoat did a very impressive job with this movie. Visual cues like the trees falling down and things like that really created this world. I'm going to give it a solid rock fist up.
Well, I give it a solid rock fist up as well, and I think it's about the best that can be done with the book. I think it's a sound adaptation. It is depressing and relentless.
You mean it's no Happiest Millionaire?
No, it actually is not the Happiest Millionaire.